So today we will see how muons prove time dilation and Lorentz lent contraction.
Muons are elementary particles having some similarity to an electron. They are created in collisions of cosmic rays in the upper atmosphere. Muons have a half-life of 2.2 microseconds. This means if we have 100 muons, we would only be left with 50 of them after 2.2 microseconds. And after another 2.2 microseconds, we would be left half of 50, that's 25, and so on so forth. These muons do travel at 99% of the speed of light. So we can measure the amount of muons reaching the Earth's surface, and they are way more than expected. As we know the particle speed and the distance between the ground and where they are created, we can calculate the time required for the muons to reach the ground. So it turns out that they would require 15.3 half-lives to reach ground. What does this mean? This means if we have a big room with 15 rows in it and I place some muons, let's take 16,384 muons at the last row, and if we tell the muons to come to the first row by the same way how half-life works, by passing only half of the amount at the previous row, we would be left with only one muon on the first row.
I guess my buddy Albert Einstein may be having the answer for this problem. As these particles are moving near to the speed of light, you have to take into account time dilation and Lorentz lent contraction.
As things go faster, their time ticks slower to a relatively stationary observer. In our problem, we, the people on the ground, are the stationary observer. So muon's clock would tick slower as they are moving at 99% of the speed of light. So when we calculate the Lorentz factor, that is, how much slow the time would take, the factor by which the time would tick slow, exactly 7.09. Even you can calculate this by the equation given on the screen. So now when we calculate their half-life, it comes out that they won't require 15.3 half-lives but just 2.8 half-lives to reach the ground, as their time would get slower relative to us. This means they won't have to pass 15 rows but just like 2 or 3 rows. So there would be much more muons reaching the ground as compared to before. But the catch here is, from the muon's frame of reference, things cannot slow down. Muon has to experience time at a normal pace. So when we see from the muon's frame of reference, the Earth itself is moving towards it 99% of the speed of light. So according to Einstein's theory, when time cannot compensate, space has to. So by the same Lorentz factor, the distance between the atmosphere where they are created and the ground will get contracted. That means the distance between the ground and the atmosphere will get smaller if we view from the muon's perspective. Let's take an example. Let's say the distance between the atmosphere and the ground is 100 kilometers. But when we take into consideration Lorentz lent contraction, the muons would only have to travel 14.04 kilometers. You just have to divide the Lorentz factor with the distance and you get the distance muons have to travel.
This is it for today. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, share the video with your friends, subscribe to my channel for all the future videos, and if you want to watch my previous videos, click here or the eye that pops up if you are on a mobile device. And as always, stay curious, stay awesome.